they gave us a conference room, which was great. It was nice and quiet, and we could really give the kids a lot of attention. But that doesn't mean that a lot of things don't happen there. We're passing out food, we're helping the little kids unscrew their pop lids, we have visitors. Every time we're there, the principal and the social worker and the counselor and various teachers and administrators, they come through and they praise those kids, those students of the month who have worked so hard. We take a lot of pictures. In fact, this time there were three brothers, kindergarten, first grade, and second grade, who were all students of the month together. Just totally, wasn't rigged at all. It just happened that way. Lots of pictures taken of them. They were adorable.
Gives him a compliment, which you always know is trouble. That means trouble's coming.
love. And Jesus knows that our relationship with God is not something that's ever done. Every day we start new. Every day we have opportunities. Sometimes we do great, sometimes we do not. But we're never done. And this young man was not done either. And so Jesus tells him the next thing. What's the next thing he needs to accomplish? And that is to let go of his attachments. To understand that God is our only attachment. He says to him, you have to give up everything and then come and follow me. But that young man, he can't imagine that. That is not what people did in his day. You stay with your family, you follow the rules, you do what you're supposed to do. You didn't walk away. He didn't give away everything. He can't imagine that yet. And so that's the very thing he has to work on, right? Detachment. Not being so attached to things and to people that God isn't at the very heart, that God isn't sufficient for us. And so the young man goes away sad. And everyone's a little bit shocked, and Jesus says, well, let's be honest. It's hard for all of us to do that. It's hard for all of us to not be attached to things and people. How hard it is to let go of things and people. How hard it is to put God in the very center, to let God be sufficient for us. How hard it is to love, as we're called to love. To love and not count the cost. How hard it is to live like that. So we all have to do. And in the midst of that impassioned realization, Peter's hand goes up. Call on me. I got something to say. You know Peter. He's just so good. He says, look, we've done that, okay? We've walked away from our family. We've walked away from our stuff. Do we get a little credit here? And Jesus says, you bet you do.
Every day, we say it. And every day, we make the